Spot color mapping in Flexi, a great way to tweak those colors and get them exactly the way you want them. Let me show you how. Let's talk about color mapping in Flexi and what is color mapping. First of all, to start with, let's just draw a rectangle here. These colors that you draw in Flexi, all these right here, these are just RGB colors. So that red, green, and blue on your monitor there gets translated into CMYK values on your printer, and that's how it makes these colors. But there are special colors, as you can see down here on my swatch table. These ones with little dots on them are considered spot colors. So if I paint that graphic right there, that red color, and I let my mouse sit over that, it says that's a Pantone 485. If you double click on that color on the swatch table, it'll actually show you that it's identified as a Pantone color, that it's a Pantone solid coated color. You'll notice color management is turned off, and it's also identified the mode of the color as spot. So basically what this means is it's a definition of a CMYK formula by Pantone to create that particular color of red. Now what happens is when you send this to your printer is using ICC profile, and so what happens is as you well know, on various different kinds of media, you may get different shades of this Pantone red. So you want to make as close as possible to your Pantone solid coated red. How do you do that? How can you change or make it even more accurate? Well, that's called spot color mapping. What we're going to do here is we're going to take this graphic, and you can do this with any spot color, and we're basically going to export this as an EPS file. And I've already done that. I've exported it as a Pantone 485, and it's an EPS format. Be sure you export that as an EPS file. Okay, so that's done. Then go to your production manager, and for the printer that you actually are using, in my case I'm using a Muta, you're gonna click on the printer, go up to setup, and choose default job properties. Now default job properties is gonna allow you to go to the third tab here, and in that third tab you're actually going to see, and it's going to identify an area here called color mapping. So basically the printer is using color mapping. So right now it's using the global color mapping, which is the Pantone formula. But as I said, it may be a little shade off, up or down, depending on the media you're using. So what we're going to do is we're going to do something called color mapping. I'm going to click on that. And basically at this point you go to import, and you're going to go to that red EPS file. So you click on import right here and open that up, and then what happens is it places it in this nice menu here. And this menu is basically telling you that to create this particular red for this particular printer and the media that you have actually opened up, in my case this Oracle 3651, it's going to use this formula to make that red. Now that's the proper formula based upon the Pantone formula, as well as the CMYK values in the ICC profile that's printing this. But that's not, let's just say that's not printing exactly the red I want. Well, if I double click on this Pantone color here, it brings up a add or modify custom spot color. So for this name, Pantone 485C, and it's important that you have that name exactly right. It needs to be exactly the same name as the spot color on your swatch table, otherwise this won't work. Here's the formula that's being used. So over on the right hand side here, we could measure color if we wanted to, but I'm gonna actually print a swatch. So I click on print swatch, and then I'm gonna cancel out of all this, and what's gonna happen is it's gonna print this little chart that you see right here. Okay, so this chart you're printing on the actual media that you're trying to create this Pantone red on. And in the center of this chart, at the intersection of 4 and 4, that's the actual Pantone formula that's being printed, and it's the Pantone color. Well, you look at the chart and you decide, okay, this one over here, let's say at X of 7 and a Y of 5, that's a closer match to the Pantone you're trying to get, or any color for that matter. I'm just using Pantone as an example. So at 7 and 5, that's a closer match. So you go back to your default settings, default job properties, go back to that third tab there. You're going to choose that color mapping thing again, right? So you click on color mapping right here, double click on that Pantone, and you're gonna input the X and Y values here. So we said that was 7 and 5 was a closer match. When I click update color, I want you to watch over here in my CMYK values, okay? So I click update color, and you'll see there was a couple of changes. So what it does is it updates automatically the color over here so that you have a better match that you've decided on visually, a better match to that Pantone color. So every time Flexi identifies or sees in a file the name Pantone 485C, instead of printing the original Pantone formula colors, it's going to print these new updated colors. It's going to match that red square that you just matched up with. Now, I printed these those squares out in 5% increments. You could do 10% increments and then do this again with 5% increments. You can do this a couple of times if you need to, but that's called spot color matching. Once I click OK on this, then what's going to happen is it's going to update my values in here, and I'm going to leave this on. And as long as use color mapping is turned on in your default job properties here, what's going to happen is when I print that Pantone color, it's going to look at my color mapping, the one that I just made, and it's going to use that new adjusted color for my Pantone color, which in my opinion was a better match. That's custom color matching in Flexi, and I think it's a great tool. You should use it whenever you're trying to get accurate color matching for certain colors, especially those Pantone colors. Great new feature in Flexi.
Guess what? It's just that easy with Flexi.